Sora! It's me! Oh! What? Stop it, Sora! Don't you recognize me?
Yeah, I recognize you. I can see exactly what you've become. How can the light hurt you? Riku, have you really become a creature of the dark? You're not Riku anymore. You're just a pawn of the darkness. So be it. It's time for you to face the light!
I'm fading. Fading away into the light.
You won't fade. You can't fade. There's no power that can defeat you. Not the light, not the dark. So don't run from the light, and don't fear the darkness, because both will make you stronger.
Make me stronger? Darkness too?
Yeah, strength that's yours. The darkness inside your heart, it's vast and it's deep. But if you can, truly stare into it and never try to look away, you won't be afraid of anything again.
All this time I've tried to push the darkness away.
You've gotta just remember to be brave. Know that the darkness is there and don't give in. If you do that, you will gain strength. The kind that's unlike any other. You'll be able to escape the deepest darkness.
And I'll be able to see through the brightest light.
Follow the darkness. It'll show you the way to your friends.
Can I face them?
You don't want to?
You know I do. Of course. And I will. With my strength. My dark strength. Darkness!
Impossible! How is it that you found me when you were there in the light?
You reek of darkness. Even the light can't block the smell. I guess I followed the darkness right to you.
This is absurd. Then I shall make you see that your hopes are nothing, nothing but a mere illusion.
Greetings, I'm Solidus-Skully, and welcome back to Kingdom Hearts Chain of Memories, where we finally take down Zexion the Sexy One. And what a sexy one, because his lexicon will be the, dexicon of you? By that I mean death. Oh boy, this is definitely a spicy meatball of a boss fight, because Zexion hurts! Again, I mean, you do have a good enough deck to get you out of the situation, but yeah, those attacks of his certainly do hurt. Again, Zexion's main thing is mainly by using duplicates of himself and, well, using his book to dish out some powerful attacks. You'll be seeing the fruits of that soon enough, but let's just say, he will whittle your health down to size, and yes, look at him take away all those cards. I wouldn't say it's quite as bad as Marluxia's attack in the final boss fight of the Rechanna Memories version that we're playing here, but man, this is deadly, dude. And see, those are his doubles. Not me, but my double. He smiled like it was the funniest thing he ever heard in his life. That's enough Max Payne references for today. But again, to In terms of any sort of boss strategy that I have, it's basically just... fight through it, use your cards wisely, and pray to whatever deity you worship that you'll get through it, because... you really gotta be persistent with this one, and as you can see here... bring on the pain. Darkbreak is actually pretty good for getting in multiple hits, especially with low value cards, which... you know, you may end up with, given the fact that, you know, you might lose a one or two here and there. It's not a pretty sight, but I mean... you can do it. It's nowhere near as, difficult as what I would say Vexen is in Sora's scenario, but... at the same time, though, I'd say that this is definitely one of the harder challenges in Riku's, boss strategy. Oh god, Spooky Boogie comes in real handy here. Yes, may your bugs replenish our life force, no matter how hard we get kicked. And I suppose, in terms of trivia, since I probably won't get a chance to mention this anywhere else, and very appropriate given, the previous commentary I did, Zexion is voiced by, Vincent Carrazza, I think? Who was the voice of, Carlos in Resident Evil 3. By that I mean the original Resident Evil 3, not the remake. And again, he's still voicing Zexion to this day, like, I mean, in Melody of Memory, Zexion has, couple of voice lines, so it's, you know, it's good to see Vincent still in work. You know? Shame you never got to voice Carlos again, but I mean, as Zexion, he's a pretty good guy. And again, I suppose the fact that, I mentioned Melody of Memory, this isn't necessarily the death of Zexion, but again, he does make a reappearance in the series at some point. But again, that's more for later. Another point mentioned I should probably bring up is that I'm also changing some of the order of the cutscenes. Because again, the one that's going to occur after the one you see, as soon as I'm finished waffling my mouth off, is the cutscene, like, right before you enter the next floor. Again, the only reason I'm putting it, like, right after this point in the game is because, well, there's a certain something I want to talk about that I don't think I fully elaborated on in Sora's story. But again, I feel like it's more worth mentioning here. I will say that in terms of attacks, that tornado is probably the most, damaging one. And you know what, I will still say, like, I didn't have anywhere near as many problems attacking Zexion in the Absent Silhouette or the Data Battles in Kingdom Hearts 2, so... make of that what you will. I guess maybe Sora has an easier time with more of his magic abilities, but... I suppose I'll save that for a later date. Anyway, with Zexion defeated, we now absorb his soul. And now that Riku has accepted both light and darkness, thanks to, Kairi, in quotation marks, he's pretty good.
After all your protests, you're still like us on the side of darkness.
I know who I am.
When did that happen? You were always terrified of the dark before.
Not anymore!
What is he? No one's ever worn the darkness the way that he does. It's impossible. Oh, yes. The replica, of course. We can use this Riku to defeat the real one. Axel?
Wouldn't you like to be real? All you need is the kind of power that the real Riku doesn't have. If you can get that, you can be a new person, not Riku, nor anybody else. You won't just be a copy of someone, you will be unique, your own self.
Axel! What are you saying to him?
You know, he's as good a place to start as any.
You can't do this! No! No!
So sorry, Zexion. You just found out way too much.
And indeedy. Yeah, the reason why I mainly wanted to discuss this little segment here was mainly to do with Axel's role in everything. Again, if I brought this up in the GBA version, I apologize for just kind of going over old ground, but this way. But yeah, Axel was on neither side the entire time. He was neither with Marluxia and Loxine in their coop, and likewise he was neither with the organization for, Zexion and Lexius' purposes. He was entirely his own agent, and the reason why he is the way he is because he and another number of the organization are basically, well, conspiring to rise up the ranks so that they can get right beside the superior and find out what happened to a certain someone of theirs who was locked inside the castle inside Holy Bastion. Again, obviously this didn't really work that well and they ended up becoming a member of the organization anyway. But again, that's basically Axel's role in all things. Again, like, as I said before, like, Axel in Chain of Memories is very different to how Axel would be portrayed later in the series, where he's a little bit more heroic and, you know, funny, whereas here he's kind of malicious and, like, kind of predatory in, like, a humorous kind of way, so, yeah. Axel's a slippery one, and, well, let's just say in his nobody form, he really was kind of, fun to be around, but also kind of scary. You'll see his more fun side when we get around to 358 over 2 days, where the whole plot point of him and his motivations, especially when it comes to Syax, his friend, well, that'll become a little bit more clear, assuming I ever cover 358 over 2 days, which will, which will probably end up being the movie version, because they didn't make a game akin to Chain of Memories, which was released on any of the HD collections, so yeah, that kind of sucks. But in any case, I just wanted to leave this here so we could listen to the beautiful piano piece that is the Destiny Island, and yeah. But I mean, again, as I kind of alluded to before with the whole nobody concept, yeah, we will be seeing Zexion again, just not in the way that you might think. Again, a lot of this becomes a little bit more obvious with Dream Drop Distance, which has its critics, but I mean, I gotta say, I enjoy that game a little bit more than most people, especially compared to the likes of Birth by Sleep. But alas. Again, it's basically gonna be cutscenes for the last part, and well, since Riku has accepted both light and darkness, we're going to be seeing the result of that, and as well as, I think a well-earned bit of respite, fittingly enough, given where we are for Riku, because, goddammit, the boy's been through so much, and, well, he needs a bit of light relief, and what better way to relieve the tension than with a visit from one of the most childlike, lovable creatures of all time, standing side by side as his total bro. I should probably say no more, and let you watch the cutscene.
Riku. Riku.
Who's there?
I know you can feel it. The grip that I have on your heart. You have led in the darkness, Riku. That means very soon your heart shall become an all-consuming darkness.
I'm not like that now.
Yes, you are.
Can't move.
The deeper the darkness runs inside you, the stronger I become. Controlling you is effortless.
Must you interfere again?
Sure glad I made it in time. That ought to keep Ansem busy for a while. Sorry I couldn't come here sooner, Riku.
Your Majesty, is it you?
Uh-huh. Whoa! That tickles!
This time, you're not an illusion. I'm so glad that you can make it here.
I made a promise to you that I would find a way, didn't I? Oh.
I'm okay. Don't worry. Guess I'm just relieved. I've been alone so long that having someone else around is a little overwhelming. But, how did you make it here? I thought it was too far.
I found a card to help me. I needed a way out of the realm of darkness. And then suddenly this card appeared right in front of me. When I picked it up, I could see your heart beyond the darkness. That's what let me find you. I guess the card thought its place was to be with you.
Maybe you are right.
See what I mean? Their friendship is just so... brosophy. So come on, let's just gradually walk over to our broski and ask the Mikey J of Mouse what's going on, dude, in his Chain of Memories unique outfit, which I think was also in 0.2, but, well, then again, that kind of had to ride around a continuity error. Yeah, we're coming right up to the end of the game, just two more worlds left to go, and as you probably saw with the card, yeah, we're headed to Twilight Town next time, so, yeah, we've come quite a long way. I suppose this was also apropos for me to show off the travel system. Again, that orb thing that you use to travel around, that's... yeah, that shows you how to warp around. And of course, your bro Mickey will follow you around, so... yeah. That's the basement of the castle, that's where we are concordantly. I don't know. Again, while a little bit more cutscene heavy than I would have liked, you know... again, one of my favourite moments in the game, so on that note, I'm Solidus-Skully, keep a new metal, and next time on Kingdom Hearts Chain of Memories, we'll be tackling Twilight Town and seeing the end of the Riku Replica. Catch you dudes and dudettes next time, and I will see you later. Bye-bye.